I'm introducing two new cameras from Celestron. These are the Skyris 132M, and it comes with monochrome or color, and the NexImage burst. Now, these two cameras feature the same image sensors. Last year, if someone were to ask me which is better, CMOS or CCD, I'd say, of course, it's CCD. But right now, if you look at the QE of the CMOS cameras, what we're using now are the Aptina chips. Those of you who are familiar with the ZWO ASI cameras that uses the 034, what we're using now is the 132, which is basically the new designation for the 034, and it's also a much improved version than the 034, although the spectral sensitivity of both chips are basically the same. If you notice that black line, how sensitive this chip is compared to the ICX618, which was the standard before, it is especially sensitive in the blue and green region, which, you know, in planetary imaging is very, very useful. So basically, you know, for planetary imaging, it's CMOS that's the king right now. What's the difference between the NexImage and the Skyris? Basically, the interface. The NexImage burst uses a USB 2.0, while the Skyris uses a USB 3.0. This chip is similar to the 034. It's a 1280 by 960 pixels. One thing that you have to bear in mind, just like the ZWO, is that the pixel size is quite small. It's 3.75 microns, compared to, if you're familiar with the 618 or the older Sony chips, which use 5 micron, this is very small. So you'll have to use a weaker Barlow. If you're using 3 times before, you have to scale down to 2 times. One thing nice about these cameras, they're compatible with far capture, which is basically the standard for cameras right now. With the Skyris, with the USB 3.0 interface, you can go as high as 60 frames per second for full frame. Some of you might ask, should I get the 2.0 or the 3.0? Well, it depends on your work. If you're just gonna do planets, the 2.0 is enough. But if you want to do solar or lunar, where you need bigger field of views, then I would recommend the 3.0. Even with USB 2.0, NexImage can use higher frame rates when you use ROI, or region of interest. Those of you who are doing planetary imaging are familiar with this one, where we cut out the chip. We don't use the full frame. We just use part of the frame. So it's called region of interest. Once we do that, the frame rate increases automatically because there's much less data that's transferring through the USB interface. So even with a NexImage, if you use a, let's say, a 640 by 480, you can go as high as 90 to 100 FPS. In fact, if you go even smaller, especially when you're imaging Mars, you can go as high as 200 FPS in some cases. If you remember before, if you're used to using imaging source cameras, the frame rates are fixed, whether you use 60, 30, 15, you know, it's all discrete. With the new Skyris and the NexImage, you know, you can use any frame rate that you want. In fact, our frame rate now works on 1 overexposure time. So you can have a frame rate of 50.2 or 71, 72. Whatever your exposure time is, the frame rate will be 1/the exposure time. What's the difference between the Skyris and the ZWO? Well, one thing about the ZWO is that some of the gain that it uses is actually software gain. I noticed when I'm imaging, especially at higher gain, the contrast was a bit dull. I didn't have that contrast with the Skyris cameras. When you go 100% gain, that's real hardware gain, not software gain. I've started using the Skyris last March. You notice a marked difference in the richness in the color of my Jupiter images. Here are some sample images. This is an image of Jupiter taken with this camera. You know, it's about the size of the moon if you use a DSLR. You can see the nice contrast in even the fine features on Jupiter. You'll notice also, especially if you're using from 618, it's quite a big leap when you use the 132 because of that extra, quote-unquote, focal length, because of the smaller pixel size. So you get larger image scales. Here's an image of Saturn. You'll notice if you look at the polar hexagon, it's very, very distinct. And this is where the Skyris would shine. you can really see a lot of fine details within the disk of Saturn. And of course, here's an image of Mars with volcanoes. You can see Olympus Mons, Mons Acreus, and Mons Pavonis in the Tharsis volcanic region of Mars. On the right side, you have Solis Lacus and Valles Marinares. The only problem I have with this image is there's too much clouds. But of course, you know, Mars tends to be cloudy in this region. Okay, do you have any questions?
What telescope did you use to take all those shots?
C14. Yes. I live in Cebu, Philippines. I live on top of a hill, which is about 150 meters above sea level.
You mentioned vessel size 3.78 digits.
Yeah.
Reduce your magnification to get the right ratio.
Yeah.
Pixels per inch, or what's the optimum for planetary?
This is a difficult question because it depends, number one, on your seeing. So in my case, where I get a lot of perfect seeing, I can go as high as 2.5 times for the 132. And I use, I think, 3.5 to 4 for the 618, which I used before. But even then, with the 2.5, the image scale of the 132 is about 15% bigger than the 618. You know, with that difference, 2.5 and 4. But one thing interesting is, you know, the sensitivity. Even with that difference in image scale, with the same gain, 132 is about probably about 5% brighter. But in reality, if it were the same image scale, the sensitivity of the red and the green and the blue is about twice that of the 618 chip, while on the red, it's about probably about 50% more sensitive. The only downside with this camera is that it's poor in IR, but with UV, it's much more sensitive than the 618. It's just on the infrared. But I have successfully imaged in methane band with this camera without any problem. And one difference I noticed when using the ZWO and this camera, especially with methane band, with ZWO, I get those vertical lines. I wonder if you have this. This isn't a problem with this camera. The pricing for the cameras, $449 for the Skyris, $279 for the NexImage Burst. If you buy the camera now, there's a 10% discount, plus if you use your coupon, an additional 5% discount.